But without any further ado, I give you the death and life of Larry Benson.
It's funny, I must have seen this picture a million times, and I've never noticed how serious he looks. That's because it was taken in a studio. Everyone stares at a studio photograph, and it's sort of nervous. I wonder if it's because it costs so darn much.
Just partly.
I'm dying to look at it right now. Jesse, do you know the only thing I remember about your brother?
What?
When he used to work at Martin's gas station, he was the only one who left to cook parts from the machine. I wonder if you remember that.
I'm sure you don't have enough for the time. 3 years.
3 years? What do you suppose he'd be like after he's been through? I mean, just imagine.
You act as if he's a freak or something. Lots of us have been, honey. Why is life meant to be any different?
After he was missing action for 3 years? Listen, anyone who's been 3 years in foreign prison camp?
We don't know that.
Sorry.
I mean, we don't know whether he was in prison camp or what.
What?
Thank you.
passing by. You know Marianne, Susan?
Sure. Hello.
Jesse's down the stairs if you'd like to see.
Oh, I think we better be going unless there's anything we can help you with.
Maybe later.
Is it alright if you come back later?
Of course. You look well, Grayson. Very pretty. How's your family?
Miss Grayson, Larry will be here soon.
Won't he?
Any time now?
I had to come before he got here.
Yeah, that's why you're on the phone.
I think it's better if I'm not here when he comes.
No. Let me finish.
You see, I'll have to tell him right away about, but I couldn't let him go on thinking I'm still. I mean, it wouldn't be fair. You can see there'd be people standing around.
I guess I can understand how you feel. He'll have to be told sooner or later, though.
I know. Actually, I think it'd be better if he knew I was engaged to Bud before.
What do you mean?
It'd be so much easier if someone just explained the whole situation. Easier for both of us.
I suppose it would.
Well, I won't keep you. The main reason I came, I have something with Larry. It's his class training. I think you should have that.
Then you should give it back to him.
That's what I wanted to do.
Not that way. You act as if you're ashamed of something. To come in here and leave his passing on the table, you have no reason to be afraid of Larry.
For a long time. I hardly talk to a boy. Miss Benson, a long time. After everyone was sure Larry was dead, I waited. And it wasn't because I was afraid.
You, Frida,
the door's open, so just walk in.
Well, I can't believe that Ben is really here. He must be the happiest woman alive. Hi, people talking to Frida.
I can't seem to think of anything.
You have a grown son around home now. Since I heard the news about Larry coming back, I thought it was about time something nice happened to Frida. One thing for sure, Larry wasn't a bit like his father and never was. Well, I'd like to tell that man a thing or two about leaving you and Jesse all alone.
Oh, a coconut special. Thank you.
I remember how that boy used to come around every time I had their nose together.
I'll put this on a plate so you can take this one back.
I'll get it, Frida.
Nuggets?
Is Frida here?
She's in the kitchen.
I see. She knew I was coming. I spoke with her.
Hello, Sam.
Hello, Frida.
I'll be going now.
Thank you very much for the cake. How have you been? You look thinner.
Oh, I'm fine. You got new curtains.
They're a year old.
Where's Jesse?
Upstairs, getting ready and wondering what to say to you.
No, wait, Frida.
I'm sorry. It's not easy.
No, it's not easy. I heard about the sewing. You're not working too hard, are you? It wouldn't be good. I mean, if you were working too hard.
We're getting along fine. Jesse's grown quite a bit since then.
Have you spoken with Larry?
Yes.
Frida, I was sure he was dead. I could feel it. I haven't cried since I was 8 years old, but I cried then. I never told you that. It was 4 months before I left here. Hi, Frida, I heard he was alive. I heard he was coming home and I had to be here.
I can understand that.
I am his father.
I said I can understand that.
Does he know about us?
No, not yet.
He's grown now. It shouldn't make much of a difference then. He's not a baby anymore.
No, he's not a baby.
It's happened to other people. He ought to know that.
Why haven't you ever called
Jesse? What time is it?
What does she have to do?
You ought to be here pretty soon.
You might as well just grab your arm and snap it right across me.
Stop!
Hurry
up. Hello, Jesse.
Hello.
You look very grown up.
I'm 16.
I'm glad to see you.
Whose idea was that?
What's the matter?
It looks like a funeral in here.
Jesse!
Mind if I put them over here?
No, I don't mind.
I'd much rather be doing something than just wait here like this. I can go to my screen. We ought to have some.
If you like. But we have all that cake.
I have money.
Jesse's right. We gotta have some ice cream. For Larry. Here. This should be enough for a couple of quarts. It's my treat. Get any flavor you think. There, take it.
Jesse, Miss Betsy, we've got news.
Happy to warn you.
Mom, it's Daddy Clark. Shall I get the dress?
I don't know why. Walking home early, picking up the rest at the same time.
I'll get it. No hurry.
Frida, Frida, there's a car coming.
No!
That is not Larry Benson.
What? Hello, Ben. You lost weight. Skinny.
Just a little bit, sweet. You're all grown up now, Miss America.
Guess what, Mom?
It's like I was never away. I'm hungry.
Wait a minute. Ben's fast is in my room.
Wait a minute. Where do you think you're going? Come back here!
Sam!
You can't just let him.
He's going right to Larry's room, just like it's always been his room.
That's the last time I pulled that sort of picture on.
Who are you? I said, who are you? What's the matter? Haven't you got any ears?
Dad! I just walked in the house a few minutes ago. What's wrong? What are you playing games for?
What is your name?
What's my name? Mom, what's the matter with him?
I'll show you what's the matter with me. What do you think you're trying to do to us? Busting in here out of nowhere, acting like our boy.
Acting? Mom, what does he mean? I don't understand.
Listen to him. He don't understand. Where is my boy?
You're crazy.
Answer me.
Sam, stop.
He's going to answer me. He'll answer me or I'll break his neck.
You better go upstairs.
Jess! You haven't even said hello.
That's enough. Now listen to me.
You said you're hungry. Are you?
I sure am.
There's a cake made out of the kitchen. One of the neighbors made it especially for you.
That neighbor wouldn't be by Jess's father.
Yes, his father.
Say no more.
Wow, coconut special.
How long are you going to let this go on?
I don't know, Sam.
I'm not sure which one I'm dreaming about most. These cakes are my girl.
Freedom. Where is Larry? Where is our son? I feel like the top of my head is going to blow off.
Where is Grace? I figured she'd be here by now.
She couldn't be here.
It's funny how she wasn't here in the house. I wonder if it's still there. I knew you wouldn't really do it.
Do what?
Throw it out.
How did you know that was there?
How do I know Wolf was there? I'm the one who pulled it out of the trash room. Don't you remember? What do you want me to see?
I don't know.
I'm back in my own home, and everyone's staring at me like I'm a bug on a page.
Grace, you were right with Benson. I had to come.
Grace.
Let's bang out in the car. I thought it was better if he didn't come in.
Grace.
Where is he? Where's Larry?
It's about time you got here.
Wait a minute. What are you trying to do?
What am I trying to do? I've been waiting for 3 years.
Let go of her.
I'm sorry. My classmate. I thought I'd give Ben the dark thing, you know, so I wouldn't fall off your finger all these times. I'm sorry, I'll put it back.
No! Where's Larry? Where is he? Somebody tell me what's going on?
I see. It's a nice diamond, Grace. Who is it? Bud Merkel?
How'd you know?
Guess it had to be him. Bud's a nice guy.
I waited for Larry Benson for 2 years. I didn't date anybody, even after. Everyone said he wouldn't come back.
You don't think I blame you? You thought I was dead. Heck, I could have been.
Stop this. Look at what you're doing to the girl.
Dad, please.
Do not call me that.
Mr. Benson, let me talk to him alone.
This has gone far enough.
Sam, come out in the kitchen.
Are you crazy? Maybe it isn't even safe.
Please, Sam, come on.
Ever since I got back, he's been acting like I'm some kind of monster. You know, you're the first person who hasn't asked me who I am.
Guess I don't need to.
At least that's something. Grace?
Yeah.
Remember how it was before? I mean, you really don't want to get but I said it wasn't.
Wasn't fair to me. You should wait.
I figured it'd be harder. If we got married and anything happened.
I know.
I must have been crazy. It's funny how you get 3 years mixed up just thinking about one thing.
I'm not going to fool around anymore. Wait, come back here!
Sam!
I'm going to grab him by the throat and I'm going to throw him out of his house.
He's frightened.
He better be!
Larry used to do that. He used to go in his room when he was scared or frightened about something.
You're beginning to act like he belongs here. We don't even know. He's a stranger and he's in Larry's room. Frieda, where is our son? Where is Larry? Think about that.
I think about that.
Maybe if we went up there. Maybe if we sat down with him, we'd hear quiet.
I don't think he'll answer you. I don't think he knows.
You don't think? Listen to me. That boy knows he isn't Larry Benson. That's one thing you can be sure of.
I'm not sure of anything.
You can bet that isn't all he knows. He might be dangerous.
You don't believe that? What are you doing?
The best I can to find out.
It's what any boy would have in his pocket.
Don't tell me any boy carries around a harmonica in his pocket. You know Larry, he didn't ever play a musical instrument in his life.
Yes, I know.
Frieda, I'm going to throw him out of here.
Let him stay, just for tonight.
Are you out of your mind?
Did you see the way he talked? The way he moved around this room? It was just like seeing Larry. Didn't you feel it?
No, I didn't feel anything except I felt everyone staring at me when he came in here and he threw his arms around me. I felt like falling through the floor. I felt like crying for my son. No, I tell you, I'm going up there.
Sam, stop it.
Let go, Frieda.
Please, you have no more right in this house, not anymore.
Don't try to stop me.
Sam, stop it.
Take your hands off my mother.
My hand where I slapped him. He just looked at me.
What did you want? What did you want him to do?
I wanted him to cry.
He did cry.
Frieda, where is Larry? Where's your son? I want to know.
I want to know too, Sam.
I'm not talking about him, Frieda. I'm talking about our son. Where is he?
I don't know. Did you see his face when you hit him? You're his father, Sam.
No. No, he's crazy.
Go home. It would be better.
Frieda, I'll stay here just for tonight. Tomorrow we'll go and we'll try to find out where our son is.
I'm afraid, and there's nobody who can make me not afraid anymore. There's a cabin up under my porch. You can stay there.
Thanks.
Good night, Sam.
Good night.
Yes, I'm all right.
I spent the night thinking, all night, That's a very hard thing to do. You think about everything that ever happened in your whole life. I didn't want to.
You better drink that before it gets cold.
I was trying to think about what to do. It kept slipping out of my head. I can't think anymore, Frida. I don't know what's the matter with me.
Would you like something to eat?
No, no thanks. You know, the only thing I can think of, I'm going to call the Army.
It's Sunday.
I'll call the Pentagon, Washington, D.C. They have every file, every fingerprint down on paper. All they have to do is call.
It's Sunday.
So what if it's Sunday? You think they shut down the whole Army on Sunday?
It's like I know him.
You're not making any sense.
You're not the only one that didn't get any sleep last night. He came into my room. I must have woken him up. I was crying. He put his hand on my head. It felt like Larry's hand. And I stopped crying. That's insane, isn't it?
Frida, I don't know what's insane or what isn't anymore.
Please don't try to talk today. Not today.
I feel like I'm walking around inside the vacuum. I am asking myself questions and you are playing make-believe, like a child.
The boy is sick, sir.
So he's sick. You're Larry's mother, not his. What has that got to do with you? Wait, how does this boy know this? We gotta get him down here. We gotta find out how. Where is he?
He's in his room.
For the love of heaven, Frida, it's not his room. I have some questions for you.
I thought if you wanted some coffee.
Wait, get over here.
He's going into the backyard.
It's like talking to a rock.
What are you doing? That doesn't belong to you.
Larry, Frida, look, it's Larry.
What are you gonna do with that?
What do you think I'm going to do? He had Larry's picture in his bag and he never opened his mouth.
Sam, you can't shock the boy. I'll talk to him. I'll ask him about the picture. He's coming.
I see.
I'm sorry. I can't explain. I just know it's better that way. The grass is doing pretty well back, isn't it?
Why did Dad leave here?
I don't think we should talk about that.
I want to know.
I don't think I can answer you.
He doesn't have the right.
You can't talk about the right or the wrong. Sometimes you can love someone for so much.
25 years!
That's only time.
I don't know how to behave. I never thought when I came home I'd be frightened.
I don't want you to be frightened.
You haven't called me anything. Say son, say Larry, say dear.
Dear, who is this?
That's Danny Holmes.
Danny Holmes?
Danny Holmes. He was my friend.
Yeah, who was Danny Holmes?
There are so many remarkable things about Danny Holmes. Like how he used to play the harmonica. It was a good sound. I told you.
Yeah, you told me.
He was my brother. Doesn't that sound crazy?
No.
That's how I felt. Like he was my brother. We were on a ship together from the beginning. We got seasick together. Danny got real sick. I swept some tea bags that I used to make hot tea with tap water for. We talked.
What did y'all talk about?
Home. He only wanted to talk about home.
Where was Danny's home?
He didn't have one. Not since he was a kid. His folks died. I think that's why I bummed around a lot. And liked to hear about me, you, Dad, and Jesse.
Where's Danny now?
I don't think I could ever find him. He's in a valley, between two hills. He died in my arms there. I dug up the ground with my bare hands and buried him. Then it started to rain. I wandered up into the hills again. It was like I died, not Danny. They found me. It was a long time. They said I was hysterical. I had the pictures of Danny in my pocket, the only thing I had. He was my brother.
Larry's dead.
Dad.
I am not your father. I am not your father. My son is dead. You hear me? Dead.
No.
Sam, why did you look at me like that? I don't know you.
Sam.
You've got to understand this now. You've got to tell him. Tell him so he knows that Larry's dead. He's standing here. Tell him.
I can't hear you anymore. I can't hear you.
Frida, I want to kill him. I want to kill him.
Who am I?
not want to hear it.
Look at me, Sam. Look at me. Somehow I have to tell you this. Do you remember Larry? I do. It's like it was here. Every hand is in, every movement that he made. It was just like seeing Larry. It's the hope. That's the whole thing. You have a son, and you try all of your life to give him all of your love so that he's good. And then you make a mistake, and you start to worry and wonder, and then you find out he's a good gentleman and begin to become a man. That's the importance of it, the hoping you do.
Frida, stop.
Then one day, in a strange valley, your boy wants such another boy just like him, almost like brothers, and death choose between them. And they find Larry, and that's when you think that's the end of hoping.
Frida.
Look at him. We're so lucky that his son came home to us. Larry shared his whole life with this boy. Larry gave his to him. We can't take what Larry gave away from him. Look at him. He needs to be loved. He needs a father. This boy is so sick, he became our son in his own mind. I want to be able to have hope for our son again. We need to be a family again.
Welcome home, son.
Back in second place. So really everybody here deserves a big round of applause because really everybody won that.